Bienvenue à tous pour l'interview pour le film The Beguiled, directed by Sofia Coppola. What a delight to have Sofia Coppola with us here. She's in competition yet again. She's having a good old chat with Nicole Kidman. Hello, Sofia. Welcome to you. Welcome, Nicole. Welcome, Colin, Kirsten, and Elle.
Welcome to
you
all.
Thank you for being with us. Sofia, this is a remake of the Don Siegel film from 1971, or is this a new adaptation of the Thomas Cullinan book?
Yeah, it's a new interpretation of the same story. So it's not really a remake of the other film, but it's a new telling of the same story from the female character's point of view this time.
Féminin. Effectivement, qu'est-ce qui vous a justement, c'est ça, c'est parce qu'il y avait
And is that why you chose to do this story? Because there is a portrait of different types of women at different ages.
Dans ce projet d'adaptation, Sofia?
Yes, I thought it was an interesting story to have so many women and girls from different ages and different stages of their life. And the idea of during the wartime, the women that are cut off and isolated and what their experience might have been like. And also, it's so much about the power struggles between men and women, which is at the premise, the heart of the story.
Oui, effectivement, c'est une sorte, Nicole Kidman.
Indeed,
c'est une sorte
Nicole
de
Kidman. It's a kind of matriarchal system you've got at the boarding school, and you're at the head. And I think you're very democratic.
Good, thank you. I love them all.
Est-ce que c'est est-ce que c'est une forme de matriarcat?
Is it a matriarchal strategy, that kind of power that you had? Are you the matriarch of the school?
I think I'm trying to prepare them for when the war is over, to guide them. I mean, this is how I wanted the motivation to be, and to protect them. So the primary motivation is to protect them, and we're there, we're alone, and we've had to fend for ourselves, and we have to survive, and still be ladies.
Oui, bien sûr, des dames du Sud. Vous soumettez chacune de vos décisions au consensus, en quelque sorte,
Did you put all of your decisions forward for approval by the rest of your cast?
You want
everyone to agree to all of your decisions in the school. It's a new take on the boarding school manager.
I don't think I want everyone to agree. I boss you around.
I run Nicole really bosses me around. I think I get the worst end of the whole thing.
You let my bad behavior slide a little bit.
Yeah, well, I do, because I know your past. Yeah. And you're my baby.
Kirsten, vous pouvez nous en dire un peu plus justement sur votre personnage qui est un peu.
Kirsten, can you tell us a little bit more about your character? You're kind of caught in the middle of these stories of power. How would you describe your role?
Oh, she's very different from me. Edwina's very, very... Hey, what does that mean? Well, she's very demure and innocent, and I think she's just been held up for so long in this place, and she isn't living her life, and she's of the age where she should have kids and be married by now, and she's trying to be a good Christian and set a good example when this man comes in from, you know, the union side.
Mm-hmm. Et cet homme bouleverse un peu la vie
really
de toutes ces jeunes filles.
Elle girls' lives upside down. Elle, I saw your reaction there.
Physical.
Your reaction was when Colin Farrell turns up.
So how
did you prepare your character?
Yeah, well, one of the favorite things that, like, Sofia emailed me, like, the first thing she said about this, she's like, I can't wait to make you the bad girl in the film. I think that we were excited at the challenge of that and how fun it would be. And also in the book, there's, like, a little, Sofia sent me, like, a highlighted kind of excerpt of it, of how my character was raised by her mom just to get a rich husband. So basically everything my character does is for the man. So, and she hasn't, obviously she's growing up and she's like hormonal and in this house, just stuck. And so when McBurney shows up, it's like, it rocks her world. She's like obsessed. So, yeah.
Oui, c'est vrai. Elle est obsédée par vous, Colin Farrell.
Yes, she's obsessed by you, Colin Farrell.
De vous retrouver
so it's great to see you here, surrounded by a bevy of beauties here, all of these wonderful female roles. It's great for your male role. How did you prepare for your role? How did you broach that character you are playing who turns up in such a feminine household?
I have a penis and that was it really. I throw you at a wolf amongst the sheep. I was the token man who kind of provokes a certain response in this house that has been a house that's been ruled by a certain amount of what I would feel would be a certain amount of oppression, but certainly a certain amount of just purely female energy. And then a man comes into the mix and he is inevitably a provocation. The character I play is something of a survivalist. He's got the boat from Ireland, he's arrived in America, and he's taken a fee for fighting in the Civil War, and treachery and hilarity ensues.
Comment vous avez travaillé avec vos interprètes, Sophia
Coppola? How did you work
Coppola?
With all of your cast,
y a
Sophia?
Corps, y a quelque chose qui
there seems to be quite a good feeling of the group.
The
women's team seemed to gel very well. Were there a lot of rehearsals beforehand?
I think just all being together, it was a very short schedule, and we filmed everything in a house. We were all together, and everybody was willing to get done what we needed to do. And we had a rehearsal period before where we learned we had a Civil War reenactor who showed Nicole how to do the medical procedures of the time because we wanted it to be accurate. And we had an etiquette teacher and a dancing teacher. And so we spent time trying to immerse ourselves in what it was like to live during that time.
C'est important pour vous aussi la vérité historique au-delà
de l'histoire, l'attraction
entre ces femmes et cet homme.
You,
c'est important de respecter la vérité historique dans votre constitution.
Respect the historical truth.
We did. We wanted it to feel connected to what it might have been like. So we tried to learn as much as we could and portray that time in a realistic way. And there's always, you know, artistic license of choices that we made along the way.
Nicole Kidman, est-ce qu'il y a quelque chose qui change? Est-ce que le genre du réalisateur,
does the type of director change the way you broach such a story as this one with very strong female characters? Does the fact that you've got a woman director make it different from a man director?
I mean, I hate to say that it does, but in the sense of this story, I think it had to be directed by a woman. I mean, this came out of Soph's essence, you know, and there's a very feminine essence to Sophia, which is very, very apparent in all of her filmmaking. And I think it would have taken on a completely different direction if it was directed by a man. I mean, I love that this is, the essence of it is feminine, and it's seen from a female point of view, and it's beginning and it begins and ends with that, and that is also there's a certain way of behaving when you're women together. I think all of us, sorry Colin,
Colin Farrell, Colin Farrell,
but there is just a certain way of talking and behaving, and that is very, very good for this. I mean, we were all living in the Hampton Inn out near the plantation at one point, and we would, but we also love the clothes, and we love all of the textures and all of those things that go in to make the film. And that's so much a part of this film, is the texture of this film. And it's very richly textured and deeply feminine.
Tout à fait. Merci beaucoup.
Indeed. Thank you very much, Nicole. Kirsten, Elle, Colin, and Sophia. Thank you so much for coming in. It's great to see you here in competition in Cannes. Enjoy the festival. So the film is called The Beguiled. It's directed by Sophia Coppola, and we're going to continue to talk about it on TV Festival right now. Some footage.